Your faith and prayers have sustained me. What I hear most often as I travel the country are five words that never, ever fail to touch my heart. That's, I am praying for you. I hear it so often. I am praying for you, Mr. President.
Most importantly, I brought my Bible. Okay?
There are those that are offended by the Holy Bible.
But my father came from a Kenyan family that includes generations of Muslims.
And as Jesus said, you are either for him or you are against him.
As the Holy Quran tells us, the Holy Quran teaches that, the Holy Quran tells us, and the Holy Quran also says, Assalamu alaikum.
Thank you. And Eid e Shoma Mubarak.
To whom much is given, much is expected. I was sworn in on the very Bible from which my mother would teach us as young children. My mother gave me this Bible, this very Bible, many years ago. And that faith lives on in my heart every single day. We are not just flesh and bone and blood. We are human beings with souls. Our republic was formed on the basis that freedom is not a gift from government, but that freedom is a gift from God. And America will thrive as long as we continue to have faith in each other and faith in God. As long as we have God, we are never, ever alone. For us here in Washington, we must never, ever stop asking God for the wisdom to serve the public according to his will. The quality of our lives is not defined by our material success, but by our spiritual success. I will tell you that, and I tell you that from somebody that has had material success and knows tremendous numbers of people with great material success, the most material success. Many of those people are very, very miserable, unhappy people. And I know a lot of people without that, but they have great families, they have great faith, they don't have money, at least not nearly to the extent, and they're happy. Those, to me, are the successful people, I have to tell you.
And Jesus said unto him, Forbid him not, for he that is not against us is for us.